connected by the church called SID Social Outreach Understanding Programme, or SID Soup. Oh, dear Lord, it's having a good edition. The idea being that we're going to look at an asset to society and try and remedy it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, health is an issue which affects nearly every single one of us. I myself am stricken by a common cold. Jake Benson is clearly obese, and poor old Harry Valentine is stricken with severe case of unpopularity. That's right, who amongst us can say they're not in poor health? So ladies and gentlemen, when we are in poor health, who do we go and see? The doctor, ladies and gentlemen, that's right. And just so happens to have a special guest here tonight. He's James' dad. He's a doctor. He is Jane. He's Kindly Doctor Bennison. Can you please give a big round of applause for Kindly Doctor Bennison? Good evening, Kindly Doctor Bennison. Lovely for you to join us. Now, you're going to be doing a full medical examination, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Very excited. Now, before you get on with that, can I just ask, you know, you've been a doctor for several years, I'm sure you have some sort of amusing anecdote to tell everyone at the holiday night?
Put me on the spot now. Well, there was this one time when this young man came into the surgery, and it turned out he had bowel cancer. That's fantastic, you know, really.
So, are you going to do a medical one yet?
Oh, yes, I mean, sound
like Wick.
Yes, good. Name?
Sid Wick.
And your age?
23.
And your name?
Sid Wick.
And how old?
23.
Excellent. Right, now, let's start off with your eyes. Now, sit up and face forward there. What was it, Graham?
Sid!
Sorry. My mistake, Graham.
Sid!
No, I'm Kindly Doctor Bennison. Let me get you a little medal on the old brain there before we carry on. Right, now onto the eyes. Now, face forward and stare directly into the lights. Okay, to the light. There we go. Excellent retinas, strong focus, excellent pupils. You know, I had a patient who was a teacher. He had terrible trouble with his pupils. So nothing matters. He's lying now. Although I must admit, I laughed when I first found out. Anyway, your eyes are fine. Your eyes are fine. You've got great buttocks.
Excuse me?
Your buttocks. They're great. Exceptionally perfect for a Jewish boy.
Not Jewish.
I see.
So what's next in front of
us? Right, we'll just check your ears out, shall we?
Sounds good.
Excellent. You've not had any history in your family of ear problems, have you?
Well, we thought my grandma had gone deaf in 2 weeks, but it just turned out she was dead.
Oh, that's good news. You know what, Graham? The finest part of my job, Graham, is giving people good news. Why, only the other week, a woman came into my surgery who had been diagnosed with a liver disease, chronic pain liver disease, and she'd been told she only had weeks to live, and I was able to walk into that room and tell her, your test results have come back and you've been completely cured.
Oh, that's wonderful, isn't it, boys and girls?
She wasn't, of course, I was lying. I was able to tell her that she was cured because I'm a doctor and people believe whatever I say. Graham, I'm terribly sorry to have to tell you, but it looks like you've got ear sickness. No! See, I was lying again. Well, people wouldn't believe anything I tell them. Right, now, let's just look at the other ear, shall we? Nothing, a bird must have flown in from outside. Right, so let's have the old card then, shall we? Pop your shirt off.
It's not really necessary, is it?
Come on, it's not anything I've not seen before, is it?
Especially when I've been watching the
window. Now just pop your shirt off. There we go. Now, I don't actually have my stethoscope on me. I lost it, I'm a pregnant woman. But I will just use my ears, and I will be able to listen to your hearts using my ears. But don't worry, I brought some special sound enhancing oil, which I shall apply to your chest. And I'll just put the shirt on. All the oil. That
That's not. Not entirely comfortable with this, Kindly Doctor Bennison.
Uncomfortable? I'll tell you what's uncomfortable. I can tell your wife that she's barren and will never be able to have children. That's uncomfortable. That's why you stole James. Now, let me just do it.
Okay, I just breathe. Yes.